Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel. Today we're going to be making some accessories. These are going to be very easy tutorials. I'm going to be showing you guys how to make them. This is a video on behalf of Wild Orchid Crafts and I will have the product list down below so you can find it on the website. So the first thing we're going to be making is this lace bracelet. So let's take a look at what we're going to be using. First thing I'm going to be using is some ribbon clamps. You can find these online and I'm going to be using the bronze color ones. I'm also going to be using some chunky chain and I also bought this online. Here is some lace from Wild Orchid Crafts and the code is on the screen right now but I'll have it listed down below. I'm also going to be using some regular chain and mine happens to have a lobster clasp. But if yours don't, you're going to need a lobster clasp and also some jump rings, scissors. And I'm also going to be using some E6000 glue. So let's get started. First thing you're going to do is you're going to measure the lace to fit your wrist. And I'm going to be leaving a little gap in between the lace here. And you'll see why a little bit later. Next, I'm going to take my regular sized chain and then I'm going to thread through these little loops on the top of the lace. I'm going to be skipping one and then I'll thread it through the next one. Then I'll skip one again and thread through the next one again. And I'll just keep doing that until I get to the end. And then I'll go ahead and trim my chain. Once I'm done with that, I'll add a little bit of glue inside my clamp. And then I'll place the lace and the chain inside there. I'll add a little bit more glue on top just to make sure that the chain is going to stay in place. And then I'm going to go ahead and just press this shut. And if you have pliers that you use for jewelries, that might help. But I just find that it's okay just pressing with my fingers. I'm going to do that for both sides. So next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to trim a piece of my chunky chain to the same size of the bracelet. Then I'm going to take my regular chain and then trim two little pieces that are going to go on the end. And I'm going to use a little jump ring to attach those together. And then I'm going to take a jump ring and then I'm going to attach those two pieces together. And that's what you should have at the end. And then for the other side, I'm just going to have one jump ring on each end. And then I'm going to attach a jump ring to the lobster clasp and then attach that to the both ends. And that, you guys, is going to finish the bracelets. So like I said, very easy. And here is a quick look of what it looks like when it's on. Next, we're going to be making this hair clip. And here are the materials we're going to be using. We're going to need a pen, a blank hair clip. From Wild Orchid Crafts, I'm going to be using this flat back pearl on the gold flower embellishment. I'm also going to be using this almond blossom flower. I'll use some white felt, some E6000 glue. And then I'm also going to be using some rose cabochons. And this is something I bought online, but this is optional. So let's get started. The first thing I did was I took something sharp. I just ended up using the hair clip just to remove this pearl from the center. But like I said, this is optional, so you don't have to use a different embellishment for the center. You can definitely keep the pearl. That looks pretty too. What I did was I just adhered this cabochon to the center of the embellishment and then I allowed it to dry. Next, I took my fabric flower and I just trimmed the wire. Then I'm going to take my felt and I'm going to just trace around the hair clip because I'm going to be covering the hair clip. The center piece I place inside so that I can trim it to size. Then I'll add a little bit of glue and then place it back inside. And then I'm going to go ahead and place the other piece of felt on top of the hair clip. I'll adhere my flower to the actual clip. Then I ended up trimming the stamens from the center of this flower. And you can definitely keep the stamens and use it for something else. To finish this off, I just place my embellishment in the center. And I love how this looks. This is really, really cute. And next, we're going to be making these earrings. This is definitely the easiest DIY ever. We're going to be using some blank earrings. From Wild Orchid Crafts, I'm going to be using this glass dome cabochon and I'm going to be using E6000 glue for this project. So let's get started. The first thing you're going to do is you're taking your dome cabochon, just adding a little bit of glue to the back and placing it in the center of your earring. And it's just that easy, you guys. I'm placing this on a foam cover just to hold it up while it dries. And here is the result. It looks really cute and is very different, is very unique. Next DIY we're going to be making is shoe clips, and this is so pretty and it can go with many different shoes. So here is what we're going to be using. From Wild Orchid Crafts, I'm going to be using this handmade bead flower. I'm also going to be using some blank shoe clips, and they have these little spikes on them. You can definitely see that there. And some white felt, some E6000 glue, pen, and some scissors. So let's get started. So the first thing I did is I drew some circles on the felt. I'm going to need 4 circles just the same size. Next, I'm going to take my beaded flower and I'm going to adhere one of the felt circles to the back. Then I'm going to take my shoe clip, and you can see here the spikes. This is what is going to grip to your shoes. So the opposite side to that is where I'm going to be adhering the flower and the felt. I'm going to go ahead and add some glue to the clip, and I'm going to place a little piece of felt. And then on the other side of that, I'm just going to go ahead and add my embellishment. And it's as easy as that, you guys. Just set it to dry and you're ready to go. So here is how you would put it on a shoe. You just bend it and it's on. So I ended up using this with many different pairs of shoes. So here's an example right here. You can have it with any kind of shoe you like, really. I ended up using it on this lace heel. And then you can also add 2 flats like you can see me doing here. So next thing we're going to be making is cardigan clips, and here is what we're going to be using. From Wild Orchid Crafts, I'm going to be using these almond blossom flowers. I'm also going to be using some more of these handmade bead flowers, some chunky chain, some regular chain, some blank hair clips, some white felt, scissors, E6000 glue, and a pen. And let's get started. First thing I'm going to do is I'm going to trace around my hair clip on the felt. I need to cut out 8 pieces altogether. Then I'll add a little bit of glue to one of the pieces and place it inside my clip. And I'm doing this just so that I can trim the excess on the end. Then I'll add a little bit more glue to the end and finish adhering that inside. Do the same thing for all 4 sides until I've completely covered the whole clip. I'm going to trim the wire on the back of these flowers as well as the stamens. Then I'll add a little bit of glue in the center and I'll place my beaded flower, and then I'm going to set it to dry. Next, I'm going to place my chains together. I measured this on my own chest just to have a good idea of the length I wanted this to be. So this is going to be a personal measurement. Everybody's measurement might be different. And then I'll add a little bit of glue to my clip, and then I'll start placing my chains. Just make sure the hair clip is facing outwards when you do this. I'll do the same thing for the other side, and then I'll go ahead and place my flowers on top. And this is it, you guys. It's really that easy, and it looks really, really cute. I ended up using an elastic band just to hold the whole thing together until it dried, and once I took the elastic out, this is what it looks like. You can definitely wear this with other clothes. Here is what it looks like on a dress. Here it is on a cardigan. And then I can also place this on the collar of a shirt. So this is it, you guys. I really hope you enjoyed this video and all of the DIYs. Please comment below and let me know which is your favorite. I have some more videos here for you guys to watch. And please don't forget to subscribe and hit the like button if you like this video. Thanks so much for watching. I'll catch you guys next time. Bye.